For our algorithm, we have three separate methods. The first method is the database match method. It's implemented by matching the database value with the 11 client values using mathematics to find the smallest mean value. And the smallest mean value means that the mean of the client values match a particular database sample. As you can see in the formula, here's just a sample. Here's the distance formula. The second method is nearest neighbor method. The nearest neighbor is, this is the method. Because the floor is so large, we divided the map into 8 regions with an access point signifying each region. For example, AP1 is region 1. If the user is receiving the strongest SNR value from AP1, then the user is in region 1. The third method, SNR ranges, is to make the algorithm more accurate. We set certain conditions depending on SNR ranges, and each condition is unique to a particular database location. After these three methods are implemented, the database location will equal the client location. Here's a graph of our precision distance. At a distance of 0 meters, that means the client position equals the database position. So here we have a difference of about 3 to 4 meters almost every time when we take a reading. And other times we actually do have an exact position. So the average is about 4 meters of distance. And here, the high points here, this is when a lot of interference occurs, which will be explained later.
So how does this translate? How do we actually come to see the pinpoint on a map? The pinpoint is basically corresponds to these 4 different stages. The first one is the layers, coordinates, length, and then actual plotting on the map. The first one, as we saw, the map is already in the movie. It is set as a layered pane, on top of which we have 2 smaller icon-sized layers, each representing one would represent the desired position that you want to get at, and the one is your current location. Any Java application divides up a monitor into coordinates using pixels, the top left being your origin. According to that, we built out 2 different databases, one for the coordinates for your desired destination that you're going to choose from the drop-down menu in your home tab, as well as the current position. In the link state, we actually link this database of coordinates with the actual corresponding thing that you choose from your home tab drop-down menus. Before we move on to the plotting phase, we actually wait for the locate me button to be pressed, which initiates the algorithm and feeds back the current position. Now we can actually plot and see where you're at and where your destination is going to be. Some of the things that we saw when we were testing is that our first and the third and the second and the fourth algorithm were not accurate enough. We had to go back many different times, and finally, which is why we have 3 different checks for our algorithm to give us an accurate result. A couple of the things that we noticed that Wi-Fi varies widely because of an opening and closing of a door, reflection from mirrors, windows, walls, as well as human traffic. One major challenge that we faced was the data communication between the client or the server with this network. This was overcome by using the software of NetStumbler. But then the problem became, how would NetStumbler communicate with our GUI? This again was, as described, was overcome by VBScript. A couple of things that we learned the hard way: procrastination, bad. Time management, very good. And remember, if you're doing senior design, you are married to each other for a year. So if you have concern, please bring it up. Don't hide it.
All right. Here's a surprise. We didn't pay a penny on our project. We depend mainly on every open source we can find to build our VIPs. The only thing we maybe spent is the pizza we used to order while spending nights working on our project, plus the man hours. These hours are the real working hours. We did a lot of work learning hours behind these 318 hours. And the final cost of the project is $6,360. This is the team contribution and task allocations. The final step is if George Mason is interested in our project and adopt it, we can expand our application to cover the whole engineering building. And another step further, we can cover the whole campus. Any building in the campus, we can cover it by updating only the database. The enhancement, we can reduce the runtime. The runtime right now, we have 15 seconds between each update of the location. We can reduce this time from 15 to less than 10 seconds to transform our system from a positioning system to a tracking system. And now let's enjoy the video. Fadi and Mr. Seth, and very special thanks to our families and friends. Thank you so much for watching.